Thank you very much. Members of the fourth estate, fellow leaders from the health sector, and Kenyan, good morning. This is a joint press statement by the Kenya Union of Clinical Officers, Kenya Medical Pharmacists and Dentists Union, Kenya National Union of Medical Laboratory Officers, Kenya National Union of Nurses, Kenya National Union of Pharmaceutical Technologists, Kenya Union of Nutritionists and Dietitians, and the Kenya Health Professional Society as a representative of all the other healthcare workers who do not have a registered union. The press statement is only on one item of the health of the establishment of the Health Service Commission. And I will read the statement as it has been written by these joint groups and of course raise the issues as they have been provided. After the promulgation of the Constitution 2010, Kenyans were expectant of the improved and seamless services delivery under the devolved system of governance. However, the public health sector has been marred with constant industrial unrest occasioned by lack of coordinated approach to the management of human resources for health. Kenyans have been and are looking for a moment when we would all reevaluate and reimagine how we govern different sectors that are essential to our existence as a country. When the President, His Excellency Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, addressed the nation on Madaraka Day this year, he discerned a constitutional moment. As a major stakeholder in the health sector, we were hopeful that this would be an opportunity to institute the desired reform as a priority given the various challenges experienced following the transfer of the health function to county governments. We reiterate that health is a shared function between the two levels of government, and we fully support the devolution. However, we note that the government of the the management of the human resource for health have been managed and actually mismanaged, resulting to several industrial strikes. That several efforts to resolve the challenges facing and has been facing the healthcare workers have not borne any fruit. Case point, upon and procedural firing of healthcare workers by several counties, which include Kirinyaga and Laikipia counties. As you are all aware, currently, Kisumu County healthcare workers are on strike due to non-implementation of the return to work formula signed in June 2019. And several other counties are under notice for industrial action. Collective bargaining agreements have not been finalized, and which are signed and registered have not been implemented as expected in totality. That under the county, we have faced the following challenges as we summarize them. Chronic staff shortages, and this is the following devolution of health function. Counties have experienced staff shortages, falling short of the national staffing norms and standards. Career progressions, counties have been reluctant to promote and redesignate healthcare workers as a result, leading to staff demotivation. irregular employment terms under the counties have that the healthcare workers have been employed under some terms that contravene the Labor Relations Act, the Employment Act, and the Public Service Principle and the guidelines. Tribalism and nepotism have been entrenched in the recruitment under the counties against the spirit of the national cohesion and integration, affecting service delivery. The training of healthcare workers has been adversely affected, denying access to high quality and special services as inefficient and stipulated under Article 43 of the Constitution 2010. Devolved staff have never been enrolled under any existing pension scheme as provided under the County Government Act, Section 132.
Thank you very much. Members, will defer to my colleagues. I will also be very brief so that I do not repeat what my colleagues have said. But what I want to say is that first, I have been keenly following BBI campaigns that have been taking going on across the country before COVID-19 emerged. I followed the one that was in Mombasa, and the recommendation of the people of Mombasa was that on top of the BPI report that had been given initially, they added other things they wanted. There was no subtraction. People of Coast Region did not recommend the removal of Health Service Commission in the BPI. I followed the first one, which was in Nyanza, in Kisi. There was a recommendation in Kisi that there should be improvement on what is the first BBI report, but there was no subtraction. They did not recommend removal of Health Service Commission. I followed the one in Kakamega, and actually the one which I also attended. There was a recommendation of addition of other things in the BBI, and there was also a recommendation from the Court Secretary General Francis Atwoli of establishment of the Health Service Commission. I followed the presentation that was in Kitui. There were additions on what had been proposed in the first BBI report. There was no any subtraction. There was no removal, suggestion of the removal of the Health Service Commission. The Speaker of the Nairobi County Assembly, Beatrice Elaji, made a proposal on behalf of all women leaders in Kenya. And in her proposal, she said, the women of Kenya who are suffering, who are dying in the process of bringing forth human beings, recommended that there should be establishment of the Health Service Commission.
That we have made several appeals, several submissions, not just to this current process, but even to the Parliament and the Senate. But it seems that we have gotten to a point where healthcare workers can no longer be listened to. Quite interesting, because Kenya is a signatory, Kenya is a member state under the World Health Organization. During the 69th World Health Assembly, one of the ratifications in which Kenya actually ratified was that feedback from healthcare workers shall form the basis for reforms in the health sector. And this is the feedback that we have given, that there is no alternative to a health service commission. That is the only body that will ensure that a Kenyan in Mandera, in Lamu, in Migori, in Kajiado, has access to high level and high quality and highly skilled health workers, so that they do not have to come to travel to Nairobi, go to the big cities of Mombasa and Kisumu for them to access a service that is their right enshrined in the Constitution under Article 43. And this is about the right to healthcare. For that common humanity, for the 96% of this country's population that depends on the public health sector. With that said, we endorse that the Health Service Commission is the only way that we will be able to streamline human resource management in this country. Thank you.